In this demo, I want to go through the steps of creating a Java method from scratch and testing it in a larger client Java program. This is an application of general concepts found in earlier video lectures, such as you'll be doing on a current programming assignment. As a quick refresher on methods, a method is just a reusable, self-contained atomic element of Java software. It's kind of like a mini program which can't be run by itself, but it's intended to be used or called from some larger client code. And it represents a more efficient way of packaging up repeated or detailed sets of instructions. So here's the example problem that we want to solve. Given an item's unit price, its quantity, a discount percentage, and the sales tax rate, we want to create a method to compute the total sales price for that transaction. The process of coming up with this black box description from this problem description is given in an earlier method creation lecture video, so please review that if this diagram doesn't quite make sense to you. But here we've summarized the above problem to describe the method we're going to create. The method's name is going to be calculate total price. It's going to have four inputs and one output as shown. And the input variable names are as shown here. We've assigned data types to them. We've assigned variable name and data type to the output. So the price is going to be a double because it needs some decimal precision. The quantity is just a count of whole numbered things, so it will be an int. And the discount will be a percentage, say something like 0.20 for 20%. And the tax rate will similarly be, say, 0.05 for 5%. And the total, of course, is a cost, so it should be a double. So inside of this method, here's the equation that we want to implement. And if you stare at this, convince yourself this is the right equation. But if we take the price, multiply it by the quantity, times a potential discount, and this will be subtracted from 1 because, for example, if this was a 20% discount, this term would be 0.8, and we multiply it by a sales tax. So if the sales tax is, say, 5%, this entire term would be 1.05. So this is the method description we're trying to implement. Let's now see how we would implement this in Java. So as always, let's start building a new program by using our template. I've got mine in some working directory on my desktop. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to save this to a new Java class. Let's call it, how about new program. I'll save it. I'm going to acknowledge this and save it anyway. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to change all of these occurrences of the name of the class to the expected name of new program. Remember that the name of the class and the name of the file have to match strictly. And let's fill in the purpose of this program. Let's say we compute the total price of a transaction. Probably do better than that, but that's enough for starters. So let's save this, compile it, and make sure we haven't introduced any errors, and we haven't. Next, where do we want to introduce this new method? So this is a method itself. It's contained inside of this class. So the method we want to create is going to go at the same level as main inside the class. So let's add a comment for it. New method to compute total sales price. And I'm going to start out with the empty shell of this new method. We called it calculate total price, open and close parentheses, open and closing braces. So that's where the method is going to go. Let's add that just for clarity. So next, let's set up the interface to this method. We're going to make it public so it can be called by the outside world. We're also going to add the static keyword, and the reason we do that is we're going to be testing this method from the main method. The main method itself is a static method. It's run in the absence of any specific objects, and there was a restriction that static methods can only directly call other static methods. So that's why we need this static keyword if this method is going to be alongside the main method. So public static, its return type is a double. So we'll add a double. And then inside the parentheses, we'll specify the input argument list. And those are just the four inputs with variable names and data types in order. So we have double price int quantity, and I'm going to kick this down to the next line for a little bit more readability. Double discount and double tax rate. Again, these are just the input arguments as specified on our black box model. So now we've got the interface to this method. So inside of here, let's add the guts of our program. And we'll indent it by the typical four spaces. And let's just put some pseudocode here. And let's stub this. It returns a double value. So let's return a bogus double value to make sure that we have set this up properly. This is just a stub value. So we'll save this, compile it, and we're good so far. So next, we want to implement the real equation. So what we'll do is we'll just put down that equation we saw in the previous slide. So total equals price times quantity times a quantity in parentheses times another quantity in parentheses, trailing semicolon. And I like to frame my equations in this way so that I don't get unbalanced parentheses. So inside of here, the first term will be 1 minus the discount, and the second term will be 1 plus the tax rate. Remember, case sensitivity is important in Java. So notice that I need to declare this output variable. So we'll say double total. And notice that I don't have to also declare all of these other quantities. Their presence in the method interface constitutes their declaration. So we're good with this so far. So we'll replace this stubbed value with the actual quantity that we're returning. And with those three lines, I think we should be pretty good. So again, let's save it, compile it, make sure we haven't introduced any errors, and we're good to go so far. Now, how do we go about testing this method? Remember why we have this method in the first place. We're simply trying to offload or outsource some of the computation so we can bury away the details inside this method and perhaps reuse them. So to call it from some client application, we just need to provide a method call with all of its expected needed inputs. So let's declare a double item price, an integer item quantity, a double item discount, and let's make the sales tax a declared constant. So final double sales tax, let's make it 5%. And we also have to declare a variable for the output. Okay, and notice something here. I've made these variable names different from these variable names. And that's perfectly fine because remember that when we call a method, we're actually passing copies of the information into the method. So it's perfectly acceptable to use different names for these. And in fact, I've done this intentionally to emphasize that point. So let's initialize these values. Let's say that the item price is $100, and we're just going to use some nice round numbers. let's say that the item quantity is equal to 1, the item discount is equal to 10%, and that should be everything that we need. Now notice that I've hard-coded these values here. We could also use Scanner to prompt the user for external inputs, but we're just going to do this simply for testing purposes. Then to test the method, what we do is we set our output variable equal to this method call, and we simply provide it with all of the data that it's requiring. So we're expecting a price. We've called that item price. It's expecting a quantity. We've called that item quantity. It's expecting a discount. We're referring to that as item discount. And it needs a sales tax rate. So we'll just pass it sales tax. And so here we have a one-to-one correspondence between what the method is expecting and what it's being provided. So let's save this, compile it. So far, so good. And then to see the result, let's just have a print statement here. So system.out.println, and let's say total cost will be in a tab, string concatenation, and the name of the variable. So if we've done everything correctly, we can save this, compile it one last time, and run it, and the total cost, it says, will be $94.5. So let's think about this. Is this right? We've got a $100 item. We have one such item. We're applying a 10% discount. So that takes us down to $90. So what's 5% of $90? 10% is $9. Half of that is $4.50. So yeah, we're getting the right result here. And notice that we can do the same thing for other input data sets. And that's the whole point of writing a method in the first place. I'm going to take away some of these comments here. We can run this same computation now for a different item, a different cost, a different discount. I'll put another print statement down here. And this is the whole point of a method. We've buried away all of these computations. We're doing the same thing over and over again, but we're just doing it on different sets of data. So we can save this, compile it, run it, and we get the total cost for two different input sets. But so what we've done here is we've shown how to implement a method, and we've shown how to go about testing it in some client test program. So feel free to refer back to this video in this example when you have to implement your own methods for a current assignment.